2012 presidential election is 5 months now in the rearview mirror, but the fallout from it continues here in Hamilton County today. Dozens of instances of illegal voting must still be dealt with. WLWT News 5's John London is live right now with a look at what's at stake. John?
Well, Mike, what's at stake is the integrity of the voting process, along with the possibility of felony prosecutions. But finding the people's one thing, proving their intent is another.
These addresses voters gave certainly look legit, but turns out they are UPS, post office, or mail drop locations. So Roger, Emily, Holly, and Scott, along with dozens of others, may face felony prosecution and not even realize it yet. It is voter falsification to use an address that purports to be your residence but isn't. If you are homeless, it is perfectly legal to register from a park bench, but if you have an actual address, it's illegal to put down something else.
If they live in North College Hill, for example, but register to vote from a post office box in College Hill, all of a sudden they're voting in city council elections when they should be voting in North College Hill elections.
Some of the now disputed votes counted because at the time election eyes did not know. They've since instructed poll workers to challenge those voters if they show up to try to cast ballots this year.
Okay.
There are also dozens of other voters who cast absentee and provisional ballots last November.
You should not attempt to vote twice.
Republican Board of Elections official Alex Triantafilou doesn't know if they intended to game the system. Some, if not all, might have simply feared their absentee ballot wouldn't make it in time. But Triantafilou says investigation by the prosecutor is justified.
If we catch you committing a crime, doesn't mean it's okay to commit it. That's the way we look at it. We think we should investigate to determine what your intent is.
Democrat Board of Elections official Tim Burke says provisional ballots are safeguards and that only one vote per person was counted.
The system worked exactly the way the Ohio Revised Code describes it's supposed to work.
Now, whether there are ultimately criminal charges or not, the lesson here, according to election experts, is that too many people take the right to vote a little too cavalierly. The consequences can be bad for the system, Mike, and bad for the individual.
No doubt. Thank you very much, John London. So the Board of Elections, by the way, meeting in the morning to decide what the next steps in these instances will be.